Hey guys, this is Morgan from Mass Photo, and today I'm going to teach you how to create a time lapse in Photoshop. Before I begin, if you're interested in learning more about capturing the night sky, then you should sign up to learn more about our summer astrophotography workshops that we'll be hosting. There's a link down in the description. When you sign up, we will send you 2 free raw files of the Milky Way to play around with in Photoshop and do whatever you want with. Alright, let's begin. Alright, we're going to go up to File, down to Scripts, and then we'll select Load Files into Stack. Once this pops up, we're going to click on the Browse icon, navigate to wherever the images are that we would like to use. Mine are right here, so I'll just click on them. Once you get there, click on the first image in the sequence, scroll down to the last image in the sequence, hold the Shift button, and click on it so you select all of the images. I already have mine loaded up, so you're not waiting for my computer to load, so I'm going to cancel out of this. But you need to press OK, and they're going to load right here in this little box, all of the file names. Once they're all there, simply press OK, and then that's going to put all of the images as individual layers right here. I'm going to pause for a second and let your computer catch up. Alright, now that you have all those images loaded as layers, what we're going to do is click on the first layer, then we're going to scroll all the way down to the bottom. Hold the Shift button and then click on the last layer. You want them all selected. And then we'll go up to Window, and then we're going to click on Timeline. We want to make sure that the timeline panel is visible. Alright, now still with all of these layers selected, click on Create Video Timeline, and that's going to move all of these layers over here into video frames. Now to organize these better, what we'll have to do is click right here on this little panel menu icon, then we'll go up to Convert Frames, Make Frames from Clips. So that makes it like an actual video, so all of the layers, all the pictures aren't playing at the same time. That puts them in a frame state. So that's looking good. Alright, but they're still all over the place. So we're going to go back to this little panel menu right here. Or actually, no, I messed up. We're going to come over here. On the top layer, click this little film strip. Click this little film strip, and then we will go to New Video Group from Clips. So that's going to organize everything together. So now everything is looking good, except when I go to play it back, it'll give you a draft preview right here, and it will be playing backwards. That's not what you want. So come back over here to the layers panel. We'll click this little down arrow to show all of the layers. Click the first layer, scroll down to the bottom, hold the Shift button, and then select the last layer. Go up to Layer up here, go down to Arrange, and then click Reverse. So that's going to put everything right, so the video is playing the right way. Still, with all of these selected, click on this panel icon one more time, and we'll click on Set Timeline Frame Rate. I don't have that many images here. It's just kind of an example to show you guys. So I'm going to click 10, 10 frames per second. That should give me a couple second time lapse. Press OK. It's going to shrink that down quite a bit. And then it's time to save. To save, you're just going to go up to File, Export, and then you're going to click on Render Video. I've already done this so that you don't have to wait for me, but you'll name the video here, select where you want it to be saved, and all the other video settings that you want. So that's pretty cool. Another thing I thought was pretty cool, this was shot a couple years ago with my first DSLR camera, and at the time, I'll show you what the original file looks like. Default. Okay, so this is the original file, and at the time I was beyond excited. It was shot with the Canon Rebel T3i, and if you zoom in, you can kind of see a little bit of weird tint right here. I knew that was the Northern Lights when I took the picture, and I was beyond excited. A couple years later, I decided to dig these up out of the archives and see what kind of detail I could pull from them, since they were all shot in RAW format. All the original color data and everything was still intact, so I boosted the exposure, and you can see there was a lot hiding in all of the black. So that is, thought that was pretty cool. I want to share that with you guys. Always shoot raw. Alright. Cancel out of that, and then we are all set. That is how you make a time lapse in Photoshop. Thank you.